Never give up. Never give up. Natalie.
Good evening, my fellow Gifidiers, Toastmasters, and guests. Let me ask all of you a question. Have any of you given up on something just because it is too hard or you are just too lazy?
Yes.
Well, I personally have given up on a lot of things just because I'm a very lazy person. I gave up on tennis after 3 months, drawing after 2 months, mental abacus after 1 month, and many, many more, because I'm very lazy. I could never learn something for more than 6 months. But do you believe that if we have passion in something, we would forget what is tiredness, pain, and sweat? When I was 6 years old, I saw a young lady wearing a tight purple leotard, her hair tied up in a bun, and some colors on her face. She was using a ribbon to dance in the air. It was not only dancing, but it incorporated some strength and flexibility, and I thought that it was the most beautiful sport in the entire world that I have ever seen. So I got home, and I told my mom, "I want to learn this, Mom." "Natalie, this is gymnastics. This is not easy. Are you sure you want to learn?" "If you're willing to learn, you have to learn for more than 6 months. I want you to be sure of what you want to learn and don't give up easily." "Yes, okay, I promise." Well, now guess what? I have been in gymnastics for already 5 years now. Even though the training is hard, I still enjoy going to every single one of it. Seeing my body is getting flexible and I can do many stunts, I feel so proud of myself. Until one day, I was in the gym studio doing Voltaire class. I leaped down the runway. I ran down the runway, leaped onto the springboard, and sprang onto the vault with my hands. But unfortunately, I did not gain balance and fell right onto the floor. At first, my neck didn't hurt at all. But when I got home, I started to feel some severe pain in my neck. My neck hurt a lot when I did anything to my neck or nodded my head. Then I realized I had sprained my neck. That was the first time I had sprained my neck. For the next few days, I had not gone to school because my neck hurt a lot until it caused me fever. The pain was unbearable and caused me some sleepless nights. I cried badly thinking I would never get cured again. Even though I got cured in a week or so, I still felt really scared. Because of this incident where I sprained my neck, I told my teacher that I would like to quit gymnastics. She then had a little chat with my mom and said, "I should not quit. Because if you know, I've been in gymnastics for a long time. And if I quit, it will waste all my hard work and effort. Because I put a lot of effort into learning gymnastics." So, recalling past few years of learning, I realized, since I joined gymnastics, my flexibility and strength have increased a lot. And I can do some difficult stunts now, such as front handspring, back walk over, round off, and many more. So after some encouragement from my parents and teachers and friends, I got back into gymnastics. Even though the training is hard and falling down is still uncountable, and I did it a lot of times, I am still working on it because doing gymnastics has always been a dream come true. Joining gymnastics was a dream for me. Dear ladies and gentlemen, it's normal to feel demotivated and want to give up on your dreams sometimes, but giving up is the easiest thing in the world. tremendous. Be courageous to stand up after you fall, and you would get nearer to your success.